Hey everybody, Alex Moen here with today's Biz Tech Tips, and today we'll talk about 25 underappreciated risks with cloud computing. And today's video will be rapid fire, and it's not intended to be anti-cloud or anything like that, but it is intended to highlight some of the risks and things that people don't really take into account when they think that moving to the cloud will solve all of their problems. So just keep in mind, all of these things have happened. This isn't a philosophical exercise or anything like that. They've even happened with large cloud providers like AWS and so on. So first, we'll just talk about technical risks. So you might have heard of DDoS attacks or distributed denial of service attacks. Cloud providers are particularly vulnerable to this. Number two, it's what's called an economic denial of service. And this can just be from the easy scaling of cloud computing. You might get a big unexpected bill that you can't pay and you get locked out of your data. Number three, cloud resources are actually limited and they can be exhausted if not temporarily for you as well. Number four, there can be a failure to isolate data between the different tenants on the cloud there. Number five, there could be malicious insiders at the cloud provider. Number six, your data can get intercepted when being sent to the cloud. Number seven, your data can leak once it is in the cloud. Number eight, there could be a loss of encryption keys. And so when things are encrypted, you need a key to essentially decipher your data. These can be lost, and essentially you'll never get your data back, at least in an understandable, comprehensible manner. Number nine, there can be compromises through the management interface that the cloud provider gives you for the login and so on. And number 10, there could be insecure or incomplete data deletion. So when you think you're deleting something, is it really being deleted on the other end? Not always. The next grouping will be organizational risks. One big thing to keep in mind is it's often difficult, if not impossible, to switch between cloud vendors. 12, if you're big in compliance in your particular field, there are compliance challenges. Number 13, the cloud provider could fail or terminate their business, go bankrupt, anything like that. Number 14, the cloud provider could get acquired, and that could come with a whole bunch of tumultuousness as well. Number 15, there could just be failure somewhere in the supply chain there. Next, a little grouping we'll cover are legal risks. These things have happened. So, for instance, there could be a subpoena on a co-tenant, so on another company that's sharing the same server as yours, and the authorities could have a warrant to be able to seize that actual hardware that has your data on it. There could be changes of legal jurisdictions as well, again, on the back end that ends up affecting you. And just some other general risks and things that do actually happen. Number 18, network outages still happen. Number 19, network mismanagement. So maybe it's putting in a ROM script or some other programming issue. Those still happen with cloud providers. 20, social engineering attacks. Those are big and growing, and I've done videos on those before. 21, loss or compromised operational logs. 22, loss or theft of equipment. 23, loss or theft of data. 24, unauthorized access to the premises where your data is actually being stored for the cloud provider. And then number 25, of course, just natural disasters happen. Now, again, that was kind of rapid fire, might be a big list, but what are your plans if one of those things kind of go wrong? So again, I've mentioned it before, but having a backup even of your cloud data, that'll cover the vast majority of the things that we just covered there. Let me know if you have any questions in particular. Don't forget to like the video. And thank you, everyone. Have a good rest of your day.